Hi guys, welcome to the PageFly video tutorial series. In today's video, you'll learn how to use the button element on your PageFly page. I'll show you why you should use the button element and how you can use it to design your page. The button element is one of the fundamental elements of any page. It acts as a call to action for wherever you want to focus your visitor's attention. You can use the button element to redirect your visitor to any given URL, scroll to any section of the current page, make a phone call, send an email, download a file, and much more. Okay, so firstly I'll show you how to set up the general settings on a button. So first we're going to add our button by coming to add element here. And here are our buttons here. We've got four buttons. I will choose this one here. I'll drag and drop just under this image. Okay, and then to get onto the general tab of the button, we come to the breadcrumb and select button here. Okay, so here we have two options. We can change the text of the button and we can choose whether to show or hide the icon. So first I'll just change my button text. I'll type in shop here. And then I can choose whether to show or hide the icon. If I want to show the icon, then I can choose the icon position between left, right, and top. And that will change down here. If you want to change the icon itself, then you simply have to click on the icon here and come to the general tab of the icon. If you click here, you'll see a large library of lots of different icons you can choose. Let's just choose this one. And you can choose the size that you want your icon to be. Remember, the size of the icon and the length of the words, the button text, will affect the size of the button. Okay, so now if we want to set up a click action for this button, which will redirect our users to somewhere once they click it, then we simply have to come to the general tab of the button and find the action parameter. And here you'll see five click actions right here. We've actually got an entire video about how to set up a click action, so you can find the URL to that in the description of this video. Okay, so now we're going to move on to the styling tab of the button. So if we simply come to the button here, and under the styling tab, we can click on this one here. The first one is style presets. So these are just preset styles for your button, for if you just want to create a quick and easy one. But if you want to customize your button, then you can come below to button state. Now here we have normal, hover, and active, and you can choose different colors or backgrounds for different states. So I'll show you what I mean. First of all, we're on normal, and I'm going to leave my content color, that's the color of the words and the icon, as white. Okay, but I'll change the background color. So if I scroll down, come to background, and here I want to change this to black. Okay, so I'll just leave it nice and simple like that. And then I will change the hover state. So this is the state of the button when a customer hovers their mouse over the button. So for this one, I'm going to choose a different content color. I'm going to choose yellow. And for the background, I will leave that the same as the one in the normal state. But I will come down here and I will change the border. So first I'll click on this border style. Okay, and I'll choose a border color. So I'll come to here and let's choose this lilac one. Okay, now if you want to customize your border, you can come to more settings here and you'll have the choice to change the border width and the border radius. So I'm just going to put in here for my border width, I'll have 3 pixels and for my border radius, I'll have 20 pixels. Okay, and then I'll click off and then I'll hover my mouse over the button. There we go, that's my hover state, and that's my normal state. So to make sure that's working online, I just have to publish. And check it out on the live view. And if we scroll down here, you can see here, our button in normal and hover state. Okay, so the last type of button I'm going to show you is a product add to cart button. You can find it up here in the add Shopify element section. Now, sometimes you want to feature your product on your page, but you don't want to have all the details that product details supplies you. You just want to have the image and a button. So to do that, you can come to product image, choose any of these and drag it onto your page, and then come back to Shopify element and come down to product add to cart. Okay, so you have another three options here. Let's choose this one. We'll put it just underneath this one. Okay, now we'll quickly choose a product for this. So we click on here and custom product. Let's just choose this one. Okay, and now for our button, we come to here and we choose the same product. Okay, now that add to cart button will add that product to the cart. Again, you can customize that button through the general and the styling tab. And once you're happy, you can publish and check out the live view. And if I scroll all the way to the bottom here, I can see my product and the add to cart button there. Okay, so that's the end of the tutorial. If you find this video helpful, please like and subscribe to our channel for more helpful future content. Don't forget to leave us any questions in the comment section below or reach us via our 24/7 in-app live chat for further assistance. To learn more about PageFly, check out our other video tutorials and visit our help center. Thanks for watching. See you next time.